Hi folks, this is a video I've been promising for a little while, and one of the rally group members reminded me a few days ago, and I'm going to show you how to change the Sturmey Archer or other hub gear sprocket. And this applies to the vintage rally bicycles, but it also applies to a lot of modern bicycles as well, as I'll show you as we go on. Now one of the modifications I like to do to these bikes is I like to fit a larger sprocket onto here, which lowers the gearing. If you're new to bikes, you can look up about bicycle gearing and you'll find out that the larger the rear sprocket, the lower the gears. Most of these bikes were geared a little bit too high, particularly for modern tastes, so we like to put the bigger tooth on. 22 tooth is the biggest recommended one, and it's the one that I use. However, on this occasion, that's not what I'm doing. I'm replacing a worn sprocket. Now, first thing I'm going to do is show you a worn sprocket. I'll show you how worn the teeth are. When the teeth on the sprocket come to a point like that, that is too worn. A good set of teeth should have a flat on the top or a curve on the top. You can even see the machining on this one. So that's a nearly new sprocket. When they start to get to points, it's time to change. Your chain will start to jump under load, and it will also wear your chain out very quickly. Now, one other point to mention is the replacement sprocket that you want. Shimano or Sachs or Sturmey Archer, early SRAM, they all use the same type of sprocket, and it's identifiable if you're looking in a shop or online or whatever. It's identifiable by the three tabs here, three drive tabs. As we take this one off, I'll show you how they fit in. So that's the type that you need, anything up to 22 teeth. However, I'm going to issue a proviso here from experience. This is the type you'll often see. It's the Shimano type, and you can see how it's stamped out of some thin metal. These are made of basically Chinesium, an alloy of chocolate and cheese, as far as I'm concerned. They're useless. It's not so much the teeth, it's these splines. They wear very quickly, the drive splines. If you ever come across a bike where the sprocket seems to turn around like that when you put any pressure on, you've probably got one of these sprockets, and these tabs, the drive tabs as they're known, that go into the splines, are worn. So get this type. Get this type, which is the old-fashioned thick type. They're still stamped, but they're a good hardened thick steel plate. If you compare the thickness here with the thickness here, you can see the difference. That extra metal is all stopping these tabs wearing. So that's the type that you want. And again, check that the teeth are nice and round at the ends and not sharp. Now I've got one more proviso to issue, which I've just remembered about myself. This job was meant to be part of the Project Dawn instructional videos, and I brought Project Dawn's wheel into the house to show you to do, and it's here, and I was about to do it when I noticed and reminded myself, pre-1952 or thereabouts, Sturmey Archer hubs have a different drive. They have a threaded drive, and the sprocket is screws on to the freewheel. You need a special tool for that. Don't try and do it yourself as a novice. Find someone who knows about Sturmey Archers to do that. The vast majority, I mean anything after the very early 50s, right up to the 1990s and up to in rallies and up to the present day in other bikes, will use the three spline drive system. Now, I've taken the wheel nut off. I've got the toggle chain in here. That can stay in there, that doesn't matter. And even the nut can stay on. Once you've got the wheel out of the bike, you're ready to take this off. Now these are held on quite simply by what's called a spring clip. This rounded profile here with a gap in it, it's actually a ring, and it's made of spring steel, and when it's off the bike it's closed up. So the gap being open here shows that it's under some tension, and that is gripping into a slot, which I'll show you when we take it off, and that's what holds everything on, just that. So the way to get it off without using any special tools, you need a small electrical type screwdriver. What is important is that it's small enough to go into this gap. This is the gap that we're going to put it into. So you need a screwdriver that's small enough for that. And you also need just a normal sized flat screwdriver. The pair of them are fine. I've got these rather splendid vintage Perfect screwdrivers, which are two of my favourite for working on old bicycles. They came from a vintage Land Rover toolkit. But I'm just going to use a normal one to show you. Right, here we go. First thing to do, get your little screwdriver into that gap that I showed you. Wiggle it in, get a nice grip. And what you're wanting to do is pull this clip out and up. Now, I don't usually do it on a bench, I usually do it on my lap. So this is going to take a few little goes. I'm doing it at a strange angle in order to show you. Now, that's gone in. Can you see the clip move out as I get that in? That's the point at which to start pulling it up a little bit. And at the same time, you get your second screwdriver in and under. Now, this is, I can feel this has been on here for donkey's years. So I'm going to just go around each one in turn, I think, and just prise it out. See it coming out there again? I'm just going to prise it out of each one in turn. This particular ring is also lined up with one of the tabs, which makes it slightly more difficult. And I'm just going to move back here so you can see, so that the light shines better. Right, here we go. Small screwdriver underneath and up. Big screwdriver underneath. Once you've got that big screwdriver underneath, and it takes a few goes, I mean, I've done probably 1,000 of these plus. And you can see how it's misbehaving for me. So don't worry if it takes you 20 goes, it doesn't matter. It does for everybody. You just got to hold your mouth right, as my dad used to say. Pull the clip out and up. And get the big screw, there we are. So the big screwdriver went underneath, and as soon as the spring clip loses its grip, it's off. It won't fly away because if you think about it, you've got your hand there. It can only fly up to your hand. It can't go across the room. So that clip is now off. Put that to one side. I'll just show you how narrow it is, that gap, compared to how it was. So that's the force it's holding itself on by. I'll pop it down there. The next thing to hold it on is this spacer. I'm going to have a little word about these and about the sprockets. At this point, don't just whip everything off. Make a note to yourself or write it down about spacers. You might find a spacer on the back, spacer on the front, there might be two on the front. The sprocket itself might be dished inwards like this one, which is normal for a rally, or it might be dished outwards like this. It was made that way deliberately so that manufacturers could design the bikes to achieve the correct chain line, a nice straight chain line to the chain set. If you change the cranks on a bike, the cranks that you put on might be a few mil in or out from original. You can tweak about with the spacers and the dishing to get the right chain line. That's what that's there for. So make a note, this one has one spacer on the outside. Put that down with the ring. Then the sprocket. And then one spacer on the inside. That's our old worn sprocket. That's going to go in the recycling, be made into something maybe. Now I'm going to show you what it's been driving on. There are the three splines that the drive is taken from, and there is the recess into which the ring, the clip ring, goes. Now this is just, as I said, this isn't Project Dawn's wheel. This is just a random wheel I've pulled down. Normally now I'd be cleaning all this up, making sure everything's spick and span. But this is just for demonstration purposes. So now we've done that. We're going to put the new sprocket on. Remember, it was one spacer inside. The sprocket was laid this way up, so it's dished inwards. Let it fall, you just turn it around and let it fall itself, it'll find its splines. There we are. And just give it a little waggle so it's nice and it's sitting down there on that spacer nicely. And now, if you're changing from one of these Chinesium type sprockets to one of the good type, because these are thicker, so you'll need to eliminate a spacer. This one has just got enough room for a spacer and the clip on there. That is rather tight, that. I normally expect a little bit more, but it's how it was, so that's how it'll go back. The other spacer on, and now the ring. This is the bit that I think is even trickier than getting the ring off. It's putting the ring on. Locate one end of the ring into that slot and feel it go in. Get either of your screwdrivers, whichever you're more comfortable using. Find one of the other little recesses for the tabs, splines as they're known, and just put the tip of the screwdriver into there and pull, and that will open the ring. At the same time, you're pushing it down with your fingers, and there's nothing I can tell you here other than you've just got to fiddle. You've just got to keep at it, keep fiddling, and it will go in. So I'm just going to fiddle for a minute now to get this in, because as I said, this is a very tight one. It's borderline as to whether it'll take that spacer on that. There we are, hear that click? And now, see the gap here? That's as big as the gap needs to be. If that gap is any bigger and you see anything out of circular on here, if it's sticking out further this side than that side, then it's not properly in. You just tease it in a little bit more with your screwdriver. But you hear a nice positive click as it goes in. Final check. There's a tiny bit of movement on there, that's absolutely fine. If it's rattling around like nothing, then you need another spacer in. And that's often responsible for a lot of clattering rattle on freewheel. So if when you freewheel, you don't just get the ratchet click, 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 but you get a rattly noise, it's often that. That's permissible, that little bit of play on there, that's fine. So there we are, job done. I hope that's been instructional for you. And again, feel free to share as widely as you want. That's absolutely fine. And I'll be back very soon with the rest of the wheel rebuilds on Project Dawn. The next one I'm going to do is going to be replacing a broken spoon.